Coming up, waiting for war, how the fast approaching deadline is wearing on already frayed nerves. Plus, a potential safety threat shuts down a Minneapolis bridge for hours. But first, on guard, here at home. Minnesota troops stand watch over some of the state's most critical and potentially dangerous sites, and that is tonight's top story. Good evening. Paul Majors has the night off. Tonight, armed soldiers are stationed at the state's nuclear plants, refineries, and water intake facilities.
Security is tighter than ever to protect against possible terrorist retaliation for war in Iraq. KARE 11's Mark Daly is going to begin our team report with more on Operation Liberty Shield.
Try to get past the gates surrounding the Minneapolis Waterworks plant in Fridley, and you'll come face to face with some serious obstacles. Armed with M16 rifles and 9mm pistols, Army National Guard members are now posted throughout the facility, round the clock, 7 days a week.
These are different times, at least for a while, and the prudent measure is to increase security.
The same is true at the water services plant in St. Paul. And although experts say it would be extremely difficult to contaminate public water supplies, local safety officials aren't taking any chances.
Our soldiers are armed, and they're trained to do their job.
Also under the watchful eyes of National Guard members as of this morning, the two nuclear power plants and two oil refineries in Minnesota.
What we'll try to do with our 225 or so soldiers that are involved, we'll try to rotate them every couple of weeks or so if the commitment lasts that long, so that they can go back to their families, go back to their full-time civilian jobs.
Authorities say a war with Iraq almost certainly will prompt terrorist attacks against America. Those attempts may be impossible to prevent, but it is possible to prepare for them.
This is serious business, even though there's no credible threat to any of these facilities. This is very, very serious business right now.
Governor Pawlenty asked the troops to stand guard after conferring with U.S. Homeland Security Director Tom Ridge and local safety officials. How long they'll stand watch is unknown right now, but their services are being paid for with state tax dollars. Rick and Diana?
All right. Thank you, Mark. Authorities are acting on every possible threat as we draw closer to war. And today, the 3rd Avenue Bridge near downtown Minneapolis was shut down for hours while police and FBI agents investigated a security breach. KARE 11's Bernie Grace has more on the scare.
The bridge was empty from mid-morning until afternoon as emergency personnel tried to figure out who might be responsible for a break-in at security gates leading to tunnels below and near the bridge.
A couple of places where someone had gained access into the tunnel complexes. One place in particular where tools were used, and this made us very, very much suspicious.
Firefighters, police, and other emergency personnel headed to the tunnel complex by the XL Energy plant along the Mississippi River. Crew spent the afternoon searching tunnels to make sure the breaches and security gates were nothing more than what usually occurs here, and that is homeless people looking for shelter.
There was transients down there, and they were caught by the dogs, homeless people, and they don't know if they're the ones that tore up the inside or not. That's what they're checking out.
Third Avenue Bridge was closed as a precaution while sheriff's deputies searched in a boat below the bridge for anything suspicious. And other deputies scoured an area near a river dam where the tunnel also runs. Extra precautions were taken because of the heightened state of alert due to pending war. There was another reason for concern, and that is how the locks were apparently broken.
You can see where they were working. They had to have had hand power tools to do what they did, as opposed to a pry bar, the kind of thing you'd expect a homeless person to use.
3 hours after the bridge closed, traffic resumed across the 3rd Avenue Bridge. The all clear came after investigators determined it was homeless people who had broken into the tunnels and nothing to do with any terrorist activity. In Minneapolis, Bernie Grace, KARE 11 News.
The nearby Stone Arch Bridge was also closed for a short time as a precautionary measure.
Time is almost up for Saddam Hussein, and a powerful U.S.-led force is ready to invade at any moment. In fact, F-15 fighters have already bombed Iraqi artillery along the invasion route. Meanwhile, a large number of special operations soldiers are reportedly already in Iraq, quietly spying on oil wells and other targets. More than a dozen Iraqi soldiers have already surrendered at the Kuwaiti border. Still, there is no sign Saddam is backing down. Today, his assembly defiantly voted against him leaving.
With an hour to go before the president's deadline expires, many Twin Cityans are rallying for peace. Late this afternoon, hundreds, by one count more than 800, gathered for an anti-war rally over the Mississippi River. Peace activists have been meeting at the Lake Street Marshall Avenue Bridge for the past couple of years. And one organizer says the public shouldn't believe what the government says is the basis for pending war.
And the Bush administration is using the events of September 11th in order to create a political climate in which the U.S. can intervene anywhere in the world in order to protect U.S. corporate interests. This war fundamentally has nothing to do with weapons of mass destruction. It has nothing to do with liberating Iraq.
Besides the bridge protest, people will also be gathering at Twin Cities churches this evening to pray for peace. Minneapolis police shot and critically wounded a man after he rear-ended a squad car and allegedly threatened officers with a knife.